Well, I've been a Linkin Park fan for a pretty long time. I think it's going on 10 years this year. Yeah, I started liking him back when I was in high school. I think it was year 9 or year 10 or something like that. And yeah, you know what, they're probably the only band I think I've stuck with that long. Only just recently been able to actually call them my favourite band. You know, kind of don't know what to expect when they're bringing out new city and things like that, but after hearing 1,000 songs, I honestly think it's the best thing they've done. So why do I deserve to go see Linkin Park in London? Well, the stars would be amazing. You know, being in Perth, it's kind of hard to see them. They don't come around here very much. Australia, let alone Perth, they've only been here once before. And yeah, I think for me to be able to go over there would just be the coolest experience ever. I've never actually even been overseas before, so for me to be able to go overseas for the first time for a Linkin Park show would be pretty unreal. So I guess you might want to see a little bit of my Linkin Park collection. Probably the biggest Linkin Park related highlight for me was when they came to Perth. I was lucky enough to go to the meet and greet because I was a member of the fan club, and I wore this flashing Transformers shirt in because, you know, what I've done with just being in the Transformers movie, and it had only come out pretty recently, so I wore that shirt into meet and greet, and Chester was just blown away by it, and the guy was really cool. And not only that, then I went back to work, you know, and a few weeks later one of the customers came in and said she'd seen me on the Linkin Park Underground TV episode, and I was like, what are you talking about? So I went online and had a look, and sure enough, you could see me getting my stuff signed with a flashing Transformers shirt in front of them at the table on the Perth W, which you'll see right now. Without fun, it can't be outdone.